Hey everyone, Daver here. Real quick, before we start this video, this is the second part in a two-part series of videos on books that are related to perfumes. The video initially was way too long. I didn't intend it for it to be that way, but this is the second part, which is on the best books on perfumes. If you want to go watch the first half on worst perfume books, definitely go up here and you can go check that out. With that, let's get to the video on best perfume books. Now the next two books are excellent. Now the first one I'll recommend because it's related to Luca Turin, and this one is The Emperor of Scent, and this one is by Chandler Burr. Chandler Burr you may recognize if any of you followed his columns in the New York Times. He was a perfume critic. He wrote two really great books on fragrances. The first one was The Emperor of Scent. Emperor of Scent is on Luca Turin. It's Luca Turin's story about how Luca Turin is a scientist who has this theory about olfaction. He submitted his idea for peer review and it was shut down. The way that's portrayed here is that Luca Turin was almost the victim here, but I think that it misses the point and that science corrects itself. So I think that his idea itself was probably not a good one. All the same, it's an interesting book and really worth it. Chandler Burr's other great book is The Perfect Scent. Excellent book as well. The Perfect Scent is about two different scents being made at the same time. One of them being Un Jardin sur la Nil by Jean-Claude Elena, and the other one being Lovely by Sarah Jessica Parker. Both of those scents are fantastic. I love both of them. And it's a really good juxtaposition in a lot of different contrasts. You know, American and European, designer and niche, etc. A lot of different things, but really, really great book. Excellent read. Definitely check this one out. Next is A Natural History of the Senses by Diane Ackerman. And this one was excellent. Now, this one is not just about scent. It's about all the senses. So touch, taste, vision, etc. It has specific sections that are dedicated toward each of the senses, which I think is great and it's fascinating. Each of them are very fascinating reads. The one on scent was incredible. It was interesting. It was well-researched and well-written. In the back, there is a lot of notes for further reading, so it's a great resource by itself. It is an excellent book. Really recommend this one. Next is The Scent of Desire by Rachel Hertz. And this one is another fantastic one. This one is about the psychological effects of scent. And you may have heard me talk a lot about the psychological effects that the brain has from scent. Most of that information is from this book. It's a really great book on that topic and one that is not talked a lot about, but is probably the most important aspect of scent itself, which is your relationship with it emotionally. If you like to read and you want to know more about that kind of world of fragrances, that you've got to get The Scent of Desire. Next is this behemoth of a book. This one is The Essence of Perfume by Roger Dove. And as you can see, it's enormous. It's right next to my head here. This one is obviously more of a coffee table type of book. There is beautiful illustrations in here. I mean, you just look through, you find all kinds of just beautiful illustrations and a lot of information in here. Roger Dove, I've said this a lot, is a brilliant mind in the perfumer world. He is an incredible resource of knowledge. Every time I hear him talk, he always says something that I've never heard before. This one has a lot of his knowledge in this book. He talks a lot about the histories of certain fragrances, a lot about notes, how they smell, how you extract certain notes, all the different types of extractions. Almost anything you can think of in the world of modern perfumery is in here. It's an enormous book. It's pretty expensive for a book, but if you have to have a coffee table book, this is an incredible book to have. So yeah, recommend this one. Next is Essence and Alchemy, A Natural History of Perfume by Mandy Aftel. And this one was incredible. I think it was one of the first books I read on perfume. And I'm glad it was because this one really had a ton of information on perfume, its history. It really has this interesting take on the history of perfume coming all the way back to alchemy and how alchemy in the days of proto-science split into two different groups. It split into science, actual science, and then the other branch split into perfumery. So perfumery shares a lot of its roots with ancient alchemy. So I thought that was really cool. But there's a lot of other information in there as well. Mandy Aftel is another mind in the perfumer world that is indispensable. She has an incredible wealth of knowledge. I really want to raid her bookshelf because I hear she has a collection of perfume books that is unrivaled. I'd love to go see her. She's in Berkeley, California. One day I want to go out to Berkeley and visit her in her shop and see everything. But one day. But as for now, definitely go get this book. It's an incredible read. Next is Fragrant by Mandy Aftel. And this one is another book by Mandy Aftel that is it's amazing. In some ways, this is almost a sequel to Essence and Alchemy, though it's very different. It goes a lot into some of the same material where she talks about history of the senses and some of the history of perfume briefly, but then she goes more on a few different essences. She talks about cinnamon, mint, frankincense, ambergris, and jasmine, and how those in particular are very important to the fragrance world. But I really recommend that you get a printed version because there's a ton of different pictures and things like that in there, illustrations. It's a great book. Next is Perfume, The Story of a Murderer by Patrick Susskind. This one I got an audiobook, and it's a great audiobook. The reader is a fantastic narrator. This was a really great book, a gripping tale about a guy with a almost superhuman sense of smell. It's a very dark tale, but it is really good. What I really love about this is that all the details about perfumery are exactly right. Patrick Susskind really did his research when he got the details for everything about perfumery. I don't know if he's a fragrance lover himself, or maybe he just is a great researcher, but everything is exactly right. That by itself lends an incredible amount of authority to the book already. It's fictional, of course, and a great book, but highly recommended. Next is The Art of Flavor by Daniel Patterson and Mandy Aftel. Mandy Aftel met with a cook, Daniel Patterson, and they were kind of talking a lot about flavor and scent, and they really kind of had a great connection there. And so they wrote, I believe, two books. Now this one is the first of the two books, and it's on flavor. And I believe the second one is just more of a similar topic there. It's mostly just about flavor and how to cook well by using your nose. And so a lot of people who are into fragrances are gourmands. They love cooking, and this is a great companion to learning to cook with your nose. It's a very good book, not necessary for every perfume lover out there, but it's really good. And if you like Mandy Aftel, I definitely think it's worth your time. Next is Floating Gold, A Natural History of Ambergris by Christopher Kemp. And this one, of course, is on ambergris. And this is a great book that I really recommend because ambergris is such a weird ingredient. He presents a lot of history and science about ambergris that I wasn't aware of before and kind of clears up some of the mystery there. But yeah, definitely a good read. Next is The Secret Life of Chanel No. 5 by Talar J. Mazzeo. Hope I'm saying your name right. Of course, this is kind of a history of Chanel No. 5 and Chanel and Coco Chanel herself. A really fascinating book. I think the author does a great job at describing the importance of Chanel No. 5, its influence on the world, and of Coco Chanel, and it really made me appreciate Chanel No. 5 a lot more. But my grandmother wore Chanel No. 5, and it made me have a deeper connection with her, I think. And it really made me appreciate her and that connection between us now even more. So, really good book. With that, I'd like to thank my sponsor, FragranceX. FragranceX is an online retailer that sells thousands of legitimate fragrances for a discounted price. If you're considering buying a fragrance, definitely check out FragranceX. I'll have a link down below to them as well as a coupon. So that's all I have. I hope these books really helped you. Definitely go check these out. Check the links down below for all the links. And if you want to try Audible, definitely go check the link for your first free book. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you next time. I'm Dave Earth, the Fragrance Bros. Bye.